Networking, security, and Wireshark.
Absolute privacy on the internet doesn't exist. It never has, and it never will. And to illustrate just one example of that, let's talk about ISPs, or internet service providers. An ISP's job is to connect your home network to the internet. So if you think about your home network here on the left, you've got your machines, you've got a home router. The ISP's job is to connect you and your network through itself to the public internet. So all of your traffic that you generate, traffic being data being transferred between your devices and Google, Facebook, websites all around the world, has to route through the ISP's networks, routers, switches, circuits, firewalls to get to the internet. What this means is that in theory, if they wanted to, they could pull a copy of your traffic. In the industry, we call this a span, or they could actually employ things known as taps, which are basically, as you would imagine, just devices that sit on connections and actually pull the data off to a third-party device for one customer, or they could be doing that for a large number of customers in bulk. So the question is, what private information can be determined if someone is able to collect this traffic and get a copy of it and analyze it in something like Wireshark? The answer is more than you actually think. So if someone wants to inspect a packet capture of all the traffic coming to and from your home, they could see two potential things. Number one is where you're going, okay? And number two, in some cases, not all, is what you're doing. Where you're going is a set of websites and other applications on the internet that you're accessing. You may think, well, who cares if I'm visiting google.com, right? And you have a point. Some sites are used by everyone. Who cares what that you're going to the site? Doesn't matter, right? But what if this is a political blog? What if this is, a party site of a political party in your country? What if this is adult entertainment? The where in those cases is incredibly important, because you wouldn't want to know anyone to know that except for yourself. So where is very important. Number two, the what. So the what is the activities you're doing on these resources, on these sites, when you get there. And just like with the where, it could be innocent or not, depending on who is actually inspecting that. Now, with modern protocols like TLS, the traffic between your machine and the internet is generally encrypted. Okay, so this is encrypted. Meaning, if someone is snooping on that traffic from either here or somewhere upstream down here, they're not going to be able to tell the what. Okay, that is all obfuscated, but they certainly will be able to tell the where still. But not all traffic is encrypted these days. It's getting better, don't get me wrong, especially after the revelations of certain organizations using things like taps to sniff tons of data from users. A lot more on the internet is getting encrypted, but it's still not perfect. So as an internet user, it's imperative that you understand what information about your activities can be seen by whom, right? The ISP, applications themselves, malicious actors who are picking up data from maybe your Wi-Fi. Because in some cases, that's just to ensure your privacy for your own sake. You may just not want people to know what you're doing, because that's just the general concept in privacy. But it can also actually mean your safety and ensuring that you and your family are safe. So for this example, let's just stick to your ISP. And let's talk about how the ISP could tell the where and how the ISP could tell the what. So let's start with the where. So very quickly before we get started, on my own personal machine, I've got a wide open capture in Wireshark to simulate the same kind of traffic capture that would be done on the ISP's network. So remember, our traffic goes here. So I'm capturing from this point here, but the same traffic with only slight modifications gets sent through the ISP's network to here. So if I can see some stuff here, then they can see some stuff here. Now, the first method of the ISP knowing where you're going is through DNS. Now, a lot of ISPs offer a DNS service to their customers. And what is DNS? DNS is the directory service or the address book of the internet. Because when you need to connect to a website, say it's Google, Okay. Google works on IP addresses, or at least you need to get an IP address, not just Google, all websites and all destinations on the network. You need to have an IP address to get to the resource. But most people can't remember IP addresses easily. So what DNS does is allow you to take like a website like Google, okay, .ca, and translate that to, say, 1111. Google is not 1111. I'm just giving you an example. And then your traffic then goes to here, right? So this is basically a big address book. Now, you could either have DNS offered by your ISP, or you can have DNS offered by a third party and use that. But either way, you need some kind of directory service to get to the internet. So when the ISP offers it, well, DNS is effectively a big record of every single thing you're going to. And if you don't believe that these servers have logs that actually will log which user is connecting to what website, they absolutely do. Now, the question is, what do they do with those logs? Which is a whole other topic we'll get to at the end. But if you're using the ISP's DNS, then definitely they will be able to tell where you're going very easily. And if you want an illustration of that, if I go back to Wireshark, I'm just going to do a quick filter, DNS. This is going to show me all the DNS packets that are being sent and received from my machine. Well, let's do some things here. Let's just move this over, move this over, move this over. And as I'm just, my machine is doing regular connections to the internet, you could see here a list of all the domains that I'm trying to access. Right? Right in plain text. DNS as a protocol is not encrypted. And even though there are options available for that, most people, 99% of machines, devices on the internet do not use encrypted DNS. They use plain text DNS. So the ISP in this case, if you're using their servers, right? If you just, they usually give you like a setup guide and they tell you like my DNS is like set it to 2222, for example. Your traffic's going here and they can definitely log where you're going. Now, even if you were to use a third-party DNS like this, right? So say like instead you said, okay, well, I don't want to use my ISP's DNS. I want to use Google DNS. Say this is Google, right? That's 8888. So instead of going here, your DNS traffic goes here to get resolution, and then you connect to Google afterwards when you do that. Well, like I just showed you, even if you're not going here to log your DNS, DNS is all plain text. So if they were to get a copy of your traffic, they could see exactly which DNS queries you're doing, and from that infer what websites you're visiting, Google, GOG, Microsoft, right? So the where, the ISP can get it in two ways. One, if you're using their own DNS, and number two is if they take a capture of your traffic, they can just look at it and DNS is plain text, so they can see the where. So that's the where. Let's talk about the what. The next time you visit a website in a browser, take a look at the address bar to see whether or not you see this little lock symbol, right? This is Firefox, and Firefox looks like this, but others have the same type of symbol. This symbol will denote that the website uses some form of security encryption in order to protect your data in flight. Meaning, if someone were to do a packet capture or get a packet capture and actually look at that data, they're not going to be able to see the contents. So if I go in here and type, you know, my feet are really smelly, help. This query going to Google, they're not going to be able to see. They'll tell that I'm going to Google, right? But they're not going to be able to see what I'm doing. And that's ideal because if you can't protect and your privacy with respect to where you're going, at least you can protect what you're doing when you get to that website. However, if you go to a website that doesn't have that security, which there still are quite a number of websites out there that don't, your data can be sniffed incredibly easily. So let's give you an example, right? This website here. Now, this is a test website. It's not a real website. I'm capturing traffic for it. Okay, so this is the IP address, and that's going live right now in Wireshark. So I'm going to do a login test. I'm going to enter my username as funky1 and my password as whatever my password is. You're going to see what it is in a sec. Hit login. It doesn't work. Now, that may have been my actual legitimate username and password. Going back to Wireshark, to look at that data that I just submitted, if I were someone who captured this traffic, I'm going to add a very Simple filter, http.request.method equal post. This is when you submit data. Right click on that packet, follow TCP stream. There's my username, funky1. There's my password, funky2. It's all in plain text. So ensuring that the resources you're interacting with are all secure is incredibly important. So what's the solution to this? Well, I'll give you a solution that will help you from ISPs prying on your data, but it is not an absolute solution to ultimate privacy on the internet, and I'll explain why. So let's talk about VPNs. So what a VPN is usually you have a VPN software installed in your machine. And what that software does is that all the traffic from your machine in and out is encrypted from the machine through your home network, through the ISP's network, through the internet, and then to the VPN server. And then what the VPN server does is that it then sends that traffic out back to the internet to wherever you need to go. Right, say it's Google. And then the return traffic goes back into what is known as the VPN tunnel. And then that goes back through the internet through your ISP to your home. So a VPN does protect you from ISP snooping, because all of the traffic in and out of the ISP, they can look at it, but it's all encrypted. It's all gibberish. This includes DNS traffic. Okay. So the where and the what are both protected from your ISP. Now, your VPN company knows the where and the what because they have full access to all your traffic in and out. They also have your credit card. They also have your name and identification. So you really just move your trust away from the ISP to a VPN company. And so, yes, this does protect you from your local ISP snooping on you, but you also need to understand who this VPN company is. Where, what country do they live in or do they work in? What are the laws around privacy in that country? Does your country have a agreement with that country about data and data privacy? It does help in one way, but then again, you're moving the problem downstream. And so ultimately, my advice to people about privacy in general on the internet is, number one, understand there's no such thing as absolute privacy. Number two, take simple measures to help increase your privacy. VPN is a great way of doing that, increasing it from and protecting you from local actors trying to sniff your traffic. But then know that if there's something that you absolutely want to do that you can't have anyone seeing for any reason, for privacy reasons, for safety reasons, try not to do it on the public internet.
That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions on the topic we've covered, please join the Discord server where we talk all things network. Until next time.